Hey guys, bringing you another decklist made by Hot Mew that he was playing at the America Summer Championship 2016. He's the winner of the tournament, so all his decks are pretty fine, I guess. We're going against another warrior. Ooh, that's a legendary player there. Well, let's start here with the Shield Slam and the Normal Slam. We are keeping the Shield Slam here. Ooh, getting another one. That was not what we were expecting here. Shield Block is fine though with the Shield Slam. And let's see if he's going for the aggressive warrior or the control warrior as well. Didn't play anything so far on turn one. So just use the armor here. Also armoring up. Shield Block up to 7 armor now. Ironforge Portal. That can give us even more armor and also summoning a 4-cost minion. Well, I guess that's all. Also a control warrior. Or might be a long match. And the outcome is most likely decided by the Elise. He already has it. So he might be getting earlier to the Elise than we do. Playing the Ironforge Portal up to 13 now, and we are getting the Frigid Snowballed. Never played that one. Spell damage plus 1. I have an axe to grind. Blood of Brave. Well, we can kill that with a Shield Slam, no problem. Could also just drop Sylvana. And then steal one of his minions.
I have no time for games.
He can't kill the Savannah with both minions because the Bloodhuff has too high life at 6. So we would steal that one if he's going to attack with both. Also, we have a brawl in hand, so if he's dropping more stuff on the board, he could just brawl and steal whatever is on the board. See how he reacts. Well, going for the attack here. Dropping a gore hole. So if he's also playing a control warrior, the brawl is not helping much in this matchup. And we could potentially play it now. And either keep the Sylvana, he then needs to attack it with the gore hole, so we could push 10 more damage with the Sylvana, or we are getting the Bloodhuff. Also just dropped our own gore hole here for sure and kill the Bloodhuff. Well, let's do that and push some damage with the Sylvana. He will then kill it with the gore hole himself next turn.
Let the pain speak to me.
Acolyte of Pain. So he wants to get us more card draws, and we're going to fatigue earlier. That is of course pretty bad. Every card counts here.
Bring pain.
Let's see, we have 4, 6, 8, 9 cards in the hand. Oh, that is bad. He might hit the Aglut for 2. And we will draw too many cards. Maybe we should use the slam here on our own minion. So we're only drawing one card from the Acolyte of Pain, not overdrawing. Already 3 cards ahead here. And he has a Harrison Jones. Drawing another card and killing the Gorehole. Getting rid of the Ravaging Ghoul. Down to 20, and that's a Justica. So he is way ahead currently. Already played the Elise and also have the Justica on the board. We are not so lucky, unfortunately. Let's play the Iron Fort Portal. And we are getting the Priest of the Feast. Interesting card. There's already the map to the Golden Monkey, so the monkey is now in the deck. With 16 cards left. And that's the Justica, so we are playing that right away. Need the armor here as much as possible. We won't play any of the Acolyte of Pains, of course, and most likely also not the slam, if we not absolutely have to. Don't want to draw more cards. Who is also playing the Nexus Champion, that is giving him another random spell now. No need to kill that one here. We have the Shield Slam, so everything is fine. And there is a Golden Monkey. That's way too early. Way too early. Also dropping the Emperor. Cheapening all his cards in the hand. Pretty bad, pretty bad. We'll drop the Yogg-Saron. The Brawl, we need to keep that in the hand. Let's use the Shield Slam here on the Emperor and drop the Doomsayer. We'll then most likely play another minion next turn, and maybe then it's the time for the Brawl. Can easily kill the Doomsayer, of course, here. Not a problem. Still have the Gorehole in hand. Wow, getting some decent stuff there. Getting some decent stuff. Another brawl. Well, let's play it. Hopefully the Golden Monkey will stay on the board. That's of course not the case. And let's play the Ghoul and also the Blood. Reducing the chance that he's hitting the face with the Ragnaros. Also, we will of course increase the value of the Yogg-Saron the more spells we play here. Wow, seriously? So hopefully he's not... Yeah, he's going for the phase, so we have a 50% chance that one of our minions stays on the board. We are dropping another brawl here. Could also use the Acolyte of Pain, in fact. But then we would go to fatigue earlier. Well, I guess it's better to go to fatigue earlier than those minions on the board. And the crew will stay on the board. That's in fact the best outcome. But still far behind here. Wow, every card is great. Not getting any bad legendaries so far. Yeah, the revenge. Kill that one, 3 more for the face. And it's nearly time for the Yogg-Saron. Well, let's play the Yogg. See how it goes. Corruption. Animal companion. Well, I don't want to draw another card. Alright, another Yogg in the hand. That's not too bad. With the nether. So he has a hand full of cards now, and that's only the small chip leather Cho'Gall. We're dropping that one. With the Ravaging Ghoul and double revenge, we can of course now clear the board if he's dropping more minions. Ghoul, we'll kill that one with the Ghoul and the Execute. Oh, still no Elise. One of the last cards on the deck. Nostromo. Nostromo. There is the Elise. Now let's play that one now. Do you have the artifact? So what are you dropping? Well, every card is great. Chromarchus. Can't leave that on the board. We have the map to the Golden Monkey here. So let's play that. And we're getting... Ooh, the Execute is nice. Could use the revenge here, or we just take the damage. And keep our stuff on the board alive. Hit him for another 4. Hopefully we are getting some additional card for the Yoxeron, so the Golden Monkey will have more targets. Well, no comment. No comment there. Our shield block is not helping at all here. So we could attack first with our minions. But it's also possible that the Yoxeron will buff one of the minions, so we can kill the Chromarchos if that one stays on the board. It's of course also possible that the Yoxeron will kill everything on the board. So it's a bit of a gamble here. I'd like to wait for the Yoxeron, the outcome. Well, looks like he's killing everything. Shield block, well done. Nova. So far so good. We are getting some weapon. There's a brawl. Should win here. And of course we get the worst card as a slime. That one Nova killed. We're not getting any additional cards with the Yoxeron, that's pretty bad. Well, the last card in the deck is a Golden Monkey. Our opponent has still 10 cards in the hand and 5 left in the deck. So we have more or less lost. Getting Nexus Champion, Daryl, Prince Huron, and the Leroy Jenkins. Some decent stuff, but we can't outvalue him here. 3 times the cards. That's the Archmage Antonidas. Of course, getting. Well. What a joke.
Garrosh versus Garrosh.
Victory or death. Second game is again Varia versus Varia. Always the best matchups, taking the longest. We are keeping the shield slam here. Starting hand again. Well, that's pretty shitty. Getting a brawl into Sylvana. So getting outvalued again here, maybe. Revenge. Another brawl, nothing to play. Nothing to play. Varia is also only using the armor up. We might face another control Varia. Yep, only armoring. Hopefully the luck is on our side this time. And not every legendary is OP as fuck. Well, I have a deja vu here, the same like the last game, really like that, really like that. So the revenge will be more or less useless in this matchup, Brawls are also not very helpful. That can take a while now. Yeah, Jessica, that's nice. Let's play her. Getting me better armor. And stay ahead every turn then. Bash killing the Jessica. He needs to play a card now. He's at 10. Ironforge Portal. That gives him the Dragonkind Sorcerer. Well, we are killing that one here with the Bash and the weapon. Playing the weapon first. Then bashing. Kill the minion and get more armor. Alexstrasza, reducing our life to 15. That's the case, we are playing the revenge now. To kill the Alexstrasza with the execute. The Ravaging Google. Not doing anything, of course, but he needs to play a card. He is at 10 cards in hand. Killing that one and just armoring up. Could have played the Growl here, but I want to keep it in the hand. So if he's playing a mini, we can just kill it without him noticing. Grommash. And he is pushing that to 10 damage. So the Growl is enough to kill the Grommash if we are also playing the Ravaging Ghoul here. Or of course the Revenge. But he will take 10 damage then. Well played. Could also play our own Grommash with the Revenge. That would keep us from taking 10 damage. Might be better. I can wait no longer. Use my blade. Map to the World Monkey already.
I have no time for games.
Sylvana Windrunner, and that one will get killed by the Growl. He is attacking now, that means he has another weapon, at least one weapon in the hand. Might be a Growl, or might be another Fairy War Axe. Drop the Ravaging Ghoul, kill the slime. With then kill the ghoul with the weapon. I might be playing another weapon then. He's at 10 cards. So we have another Fairy War Axe. All those useless cards at the moment. Not very happy with that. Playing the Iron Forge portal and getting, well, a 1-1. That is summoning a 5-5. Might shield slam that. Oh, he's drawing another card. Not very clever in this matchup. Ironforge portal. See what he's getting. Magi. Spell damage plus 1, 4-4. Killing that one for sure. Why are you playing that? You are only at 9 cards. There's a Yogg-Saron. Don't want to play it at the moment. Our hand is way too full, so if we are drawing more cards, they will just be wasted. So we don't want to play the Acolyte of Pain here. Don't want to drop the Sylvana in general. Let's just play the Ravaging Ghoul here. And again, the Elise is at the bottom of the deck. Killing the ghoul with the bash. Well, we need to play something here. Can't play the Acolyte of Pain, we will just draw more cards. So it doesn't matter if we play the Acolyte of Pain or keep it in the hand. And the only other cards that we can play are the Fairy War Axe and the Sylvana. Want to keep the Gorehole at the moment, so we are playing the Sylvana. He will just kill her, but it doesn't matter. Shield slam. Yep. Uh. 38 damage on the Sylvana is way enough. How seriously? What a joke. Oh, let's hit him here with the Gorehole and play the Fairy War Axe. I know who has a better weapon now. Ironforge portal, that one is fine. You're playing a minion, you will just kill it, of course. There is a... Wow, that's so worse. 42, not good stats. Hitting it with a slam, saving a card there. And finally the Elise. Nice to see you. Nice to see you indeed. So we are now one card ahead. Hardy already has the map to the Golden Monkey played. So he could have the Golden Monkey in hand. And then the go hole will be pretty strong. You only have then minions in the hand, and the go hole can kill all minions, keeping the board safe for him. Execute. Not attacking with the weapon here, interesting. Shield slam. Well, let's use the slam, killing the slime. And more armor. Doomsayer. We need to play a card here, I guess. 6, 8, 10 cards. We don't want to play the Aglute of Pain. Also don't want to play the Oxoron. So the Doomsayer is by far the best choice. Playing the Acolyte of Pain. That might be painful. But of course the Doomsayer is killing it. Shield block. Hell, the shield block. Do we want to play the shield block? Seriously, getting another one.
I'm almost out of cards.
And the bash. Okay, so the last card is a map to the Gold Monkey. There's a map to the Gold Monkey, we are playing that one. Then let's drop the Golden Monkey. See what we are getting here. Ooh, double Elise. Double Elise is nice, we can fill our deck then. And the rest is also pretty great. So we are using the Elise here.
You have the artifact.
And shoveling another map to the Golden Monkey into our deck. We are drawing that one, but we are playing the Elise next turn again. We get another map to the Golden Monkey. Creating more cards. That finally is Jessica Trueheart. Shield slam on the Golden Monkey. And he should have killed the Elise Starseeker here as well. So we are doing it. Play another Elise. Kill the Justica. Let's hit him in the face for 3. And he still has a brawl in hand. So we don't want to play more minions. Pretty happy with the legendaries we got, so I'm not sure if we want to play another monkey into the deck. We might use the card for the end to get another 6/6 on the board.
Prepare to face the mighty
Milhouse Mana Storm. And an Edwin. So I guess we are playing the Edric the Pure next turn. Then we are playing the map to the Golden Monkey for free. Because of the Milhouse Mana Storm. We are currently ahead in cards. The Gorehole is a bit of a bummer here. He can kill most of our minions. But we still should be fine. Ragnaros, we can kill that one with a King Crush. So hopefully the Ragnaros is not killing the Elise. That would be bad. Want to have her on the board so we can kill the Edwin. He's killing it, unfortunately. So let's use the King Crush to kill the Ragnaros. Nefarian will also give us more cards into the hand. Oh, that's also not too bad. Playing the Nefarian now, getting two more cards. Bolster and a slam. The bolster, we can increase the stats of the curator. Seriously? We need to play the slam here. Taking out the Alakia. And then let's play the Ball of Ram Shield. Doesn't look too good at the moment.
The menagerie is for guests only.
Let's engage.
But let's wait and see how it goes in the end. Only has one card left in the hand. Ogre's pretty ugly at the moment. Taking 6 damage here, we are going for the Gromash, killing both his minions. Should attack here with the weapon. Taking out our Nefarian.
What now?
Well, just go to the face.
Ah.
Why would you do that? You could have killed the Nefarian here. So he's leaving the Hova, one card left. We might get too much damage here. So the last card is a Lorewalker Show. That is not helping at all. That will be pretty close. We're playing the Golden Monkey now. Getting another legendary there. Ooh, and that is great. Let's hit him for another 14. Taking 9 damage here. So I guess we should win the game. Taking 9 damage. That will be 10 next turn. Guess we don't need the scenarios. We will just hit him further in the face with the minions and win the game then. We will lose next turn. Made a few mistakes there. He should have kept the Hoga. That could have brought him the victory.
And that's the conclusion of today's episode. Thank you for watching. If you like my content and want to see more of it, check out my other stuff on the channel or simply hit the thumbnails in the end card you are seeing right now. You can always reach out to me in the comments with feedback or deck requests, so don't be shy. Last but not least, if you want to support me, you can do so in various ways. Subscribe to my channel, follow me on Twitter and Twitch, or use my affiliate partners, which can be found in the description box below the video. It will allow me to keep the channel and new content coming in on a regular basis. Until then, see you in my next video and goodbye.